Ladies and gentlemen, please take your seats. Thank you so much for coming tonight at the sixth and last session, final session of this series. And I'm grateful for your true participation during this the series, which started in the summer of this year, and which brought to us one overarching conclusion, and that was that the world map of demography is changing rapidly, like we indeed 15 years ago, Mr. Baneke, we were organizing together a series on the world map on poverty, and we were one of the first, you were one of the first to underscore that there were no any longer blocks, the south and the north. There was a changing map of poverty, and now there is a changing map of demography, dramatically changing. We were confronted with a prominent position in the Netherlands from the 70s on. We were leading, some say, we were at least prominent in the development of the debate on demography during the 70s, during the 80s, during the 90s. Others say so, but one of the striking conclusions of this series has been that, our relative prominent position has not been turned into an advantage in these days. Are we still able? Have we not become a little bit lazy? Should we not innovate this debate? There was a certain confusion all over the time. Some use still the Neo-Malthusian approach, or better, analysis. Other accentuated, underscored the normal demographic transition in countries going to technological and economic progress. Again, others underscored the problem of aging populations and falling fertility, as foreign policy did 5 years ago already, and the economists know 2 weeks ago. And again, others strongly fostered, promoted the rights approach. And there was, of course, the new environmental issue. Well, we need, in the debate that came out clearly in all our lectures, innovation, new arguments. We have to conduct the discussion about demography in with the arguments and the debate of the 21st century, and not any longer of the 20th century. And that is, I think, a conclusion which is part also of the approach of Society for International Society for Development, with our emphasis on new scarcities 2 years ago, with our emphasis on the common good and economic growth, and now with our emphasis on the financial crisis, and finally, the demography. And in this respect, I'm most welcome. I'm honored and proud that we can welcome tonight Professor Steve Sinding and Minister Koenders. But Minister Koenders is on his way to this meeting. He phoned us telling that we should start because he had parliamentary obligations, and he will arrive in, I think, 5 minutes. So, Professor Steve Sinding is known to many in the audience as one of the architects of the Cairo Program of Action, which he contributed to as a member of the United States delegation to the International Conference on Population and Development, better known as Cairo 1994. He has a distinguished career in the field of population research, policy analysis and advice, and at the moment he is a senior fellow at the Guttmacher Institute of in the USA. Professor Sinding, we are extremely honored and pleased that you will come over, take the trouble to come over tonight from the States to this final conference, this final meeting and session and that you would, well, insert with your ideas, well, the so much needed innovation in our debate. And we appreciate that very much. Later I will welcome Minister Koenders. Now I may give the floor to you, Professor Sandy.
Well, thank you for that very kind introduction. It's really a pleasure to be back in The Hague and in the Netherlands, a city and a nation that have contributed immensely to efforts over the years to address intelligently issues of world population growth and to propose sensible and effective measures to deal with them. As in so many other matters, the Dutch have surmounted mountains of ideology on the subject of population to arrive at a practical understanding of the nature of demographic problems and to put forward sound approaches to their solution. Nothing better illustrates this point than the success of the 1999 Hague Forum to review the first 5 years' performance of the implementation of the Cairo Program of Action. A meeting I attended, and I think it was my last time in The Hague, so I'm particularly pleased to be back here. You asked the right questions then, and you're asking the right questions today. Is rapid population growth still an important global issue? If so, what interventions are compatible with today's development thinking? I like very much the way you framed the second question. What approaches are compatible with today's development thinking? Because so much of the debate continues to be about yesterday's development thinking. I want to congratulate the Society for International Development here in the Netherlands and the World Population Foundation for hosting this interesting and enlightening series of lectures, which I've been able to follow actually by streaming the videos of the former speakers. And I know how excellent they've been. You made wonderful choices in the people you invited before me, and I only hope you can I can justify your decision to invite me to join that distinguished group. For those of you who have managed to attend all of the previous ones, you're probably surprised not to see a screen with PowerPoint, because I think you've been inundated with data. And I'm not going to do that. It seemed to me that the purpose of inviting me to come last was in some ways to try to tie this together more in a policy than in an analytic sense. And so that's what I'm going to try to do. Let's go over a little bit of background at the risk of boring some of you or going over ground that's very familiar. I think for all of us to get to where I want to go, it's important to rehearse a bit of history. The world's very different today than it was in 1973 when the president of the World Bank, Robert McNamara, called population growth after the threat of thermonuclear war the most pressing and complex problem facing mankind. Those were strong words, words that no person in a similar position probably would utter today. McNamara was reflecting the liberal development consensus of that time, a consensus upon which a very large cooperative effort among industrialized countries was undertaken to export throughout the developing world a commitment to reducing high fertility rates, primarily through family planning programs. Most development economists of that era, which lasted from the 1950s until the mid-1980s, concurred with the view that rapid population growth represented a serious barrier to economic growth. This view had its origins, I suppose, in the writings of Reverend Malthus over a century and a half earlier, but its modern manifestation was most famously set forth in a 1958 book by Ansley Cole and Edgar Hoover, entitled Population Growth and Economic Development in Low-Income Countries.